He who comes to God must know that he is and is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. With you.
recount a great wonder of God. 3 weeks ago, while we were on our 7 a.m. morning prayers, and just in between the prayers, I had a spirit of God said to me that there is someone that is beside a dead woman. And then the spirit of God begins to say to me, tell the person to increase the volume of the phone and place it right beside the dead woman. And as the testimony was eventually going to enter, and the person said that as soon as they heard that, meanwhile, few hours before the time, their mom had just been confirmed clinically dead. Clinically dead. The doctors had confirmed, and they were lamenting. And it didn't make sense that in the middle of that kind of pain, that their sister was listening to a prayer going on the phone. But as soon as the word of knowledge came, she increased the volume and placed it right beside their mother. And the prayers were going on and on and on and on and on and on. And she said, Pastor, by the time you were done praying, Shiborandikasa. And she said, we waited for my mom to come back to life. And she didn't come back to life. And it felt like her world was tumbling right down on her. And then she had questions on her mind. Was it true that God said? Could it be true that that wasn't God? Was it not my mom that God was talking about? And she felt God had really disappointed them. But people of God, 5 minutes later, 5 minutes later, 5 minutes later, Karudaba Shakadaya, Ali Barakaza, for the scripture says, how many of you will your children ask for bread and you will give them a stone? How many of you will your children ask for fish and you will give them a snake? Hashudaba, the Bible says, and women received their dead back to life. Shokarabaza, we are in a season of a revival of the strange acts of God. A revival of the strange acts of God. No longer what the people ask us, where is your God? While we were dealing with that, another woman brought in another testimony. And she said, before I joined the morning prayers, my husband had been operated on because of brain cancer. And then she said, while coming on the prayer, her faith was totally built up. And then the husband was operated and the husband was unconscious. And the doctor came and told her, I said, woman, we really tried to avoid the corridors, some sensitive corridors. He said, but we couldn't. And he said, I'm afraid to tell you, your husband will not recover for the next 6 months. That is, he will become conscious in the next 6 months. And he may never walk. He may never walk. He may never walk. And the woman replied, the doctor, what God cannot do does not exist. Ashabalika, Arabadusaya. And the woman, the doctor replied, the woman, Ashubaraha, you think I'm not making sense? The woman said, I didn't say that. What I am saying is, what God cannot do does not exist. And so the doctor goes to the brother-in-law and begins to tell the brother-in-law to warn the woman about her behavior.
Oh, what you cannot call does not exist. Pastor Jerry Hazen.
Exactly 3 weeks ago, and it's such a blessing to recount a great wonder of God. 3 weeks ago, while we were on our 7 a.m. morning prayers, and just in between the prayers, I had a spirit of God said to me that there is someone that is beside a dead woman. And then the Spirit of God begins to say to me, tell the person to increase the volume of the phone and place it right beside the dead woman. And as the testimony was eventually going to enter, and the person said that as soon as they heard that, meanwhile, few hours before the time, their mom had just been confirmed clinically dead. Clinically dead. The doctors had confirmed and they were lamenting. And it didn't make sense that in the middle of that kind of pain, that their sister was listening to a prayer going on the phone. But as soon as the word of knowledge came, she increased the volume and placed it right beside their mother. And the prayers were going on and on and on and on and on and on. And she said, Pastor, by the time you were done praying, Shivorandikasa. And she said, we waited for my mom to come back to life. And she didn't come back to life. And it felt like her world was tumbling right down on her. And then she had questions on her mind. Was it true that God said? Could it be true that that wasn't God? Was it not my mom that God was talking about? And she felt God had really disappointed them. But people of God, 5 minutes later, 5 minutes later, 5 minutes later, for the scripture says, how many of you will your children ask for bread and you will give them a stone? How many of you will your children ask for fish and you will give them a snake? The Bible says, and women received their dead back to life. We are in a season of a revival of the strange acts of God. A revival of the strange acts of God. No longer would the people ask us, where is your God? While we were dealing with that, another woman brought in another testimony. And she said, before I joined the morning prayers, my husband had been operated on because of brain cancer. And then she said, while coming on the prayer, her faith was totally built up. And then the husband was operated and the husband was unconscious. And the doctor came and told her, I said, woman, we really tried to avoid the corridors, some sensitive corridors. He said, but we couldn't. And he said, I'm afraid to tell you, your husband will not recover for the next 6 months. That is, he will become conscious in the next 6 months. And he may never walk. He may never walk. He may never walk. And the woman replied, the doctor, what God cannot do does not exist. Ashabalika, Arabadusaya. And the woman, the doctor replied, the woman, Ashubaraha, you think I'm not making sense? The woman said, I didn't say that. What I am saying is, what God cannot do does not exist. And so the doctor goes to the brother-in-law and begins to tell the brother-in-law to warn the woman about her behavior. And people of God, Shandi Kasara, Hila Borosha, few hours after they wheeled the husband out and put the husband in the ICU, the woman walked straight to where the husband was and said to God, you are too faithful to fail. I trust you too much. My faith has risen. For the Bible says, for now, faith, now, faith is now. It is not tomorrow. There are people listening to this song and God is saying, right now, right now. For the Bible says, while Jesus was yet speaking, while he was yet speaking, while he was yet speaking, and the woman said, I went straight to where my husband was. And the woman called the husband's name. Who does that? It doesn't make sense. Even if he's going to wake up, this is a few hours after a brain surgery. And the woman called the husband's name. And the husband responded and opened his eyes. And opened his eyes. Let's take it up again. And the woman said that after the husband recovered, the doctors came in and were looking, and the doctor called the man, and the man responded, and the woman and the doctor, everybody was amazed. But this is not the catch. Look at the one that blew me off. Look at the one that made me cry. Look at the one that made me say, there is no one like our God. And that is the fact that when they came to move the man out of the ICU, to move the man into the ward, they now removed the window blades. And the woman was asking, why are you removing the window blades? And they said, the door cannot take the stretcher, and so we need to move the man out from the window. We're going to move him out. Don't forget that the expert said, you will not be able to stand. You cannot stand for another 1 year. But people of God, while they were thinking about how to move the man from the stretcher out of the window, Shika, the man stood up on his feet. The same Jesus, yesterday, today, and forever. And the woman said, she kept screaming, what God cannot do does not exist. What God cannot do does not. What God cannot do does not.
Lift your voice and say, we
what you cannot do.